Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Today, we're going to remove this beautiful harmonic balancer because maybe we're going into here to change that seal that always leaks oil, or maybe we got to change the timing chain because it's a rattling, or we're going to be rebuilding this engine. This guy has to come off. Let's go!
The harmonic balancer is two pieces of metal, a big hefty piece of steel here and a big hefty piece of steel here around the outside. It is glued together through this rubber band, and the point of it is if there's any vibrations or weird kind of fluctuations or pulses or whatever that are happening through the entire crankshaft between all the in the combustion pulses, if there's any weird vibration, these two can kind of move apart a little bit, cushioned by that rubber elastic. And that absorbs some vibration in the crankshaft.
In the tool room, you're going to find a couple different harmonic balancers. This one removes the harmonic balancer, okay? It does not put it on, but it removes it. And this guy works like so. You've got this crazy guy. There's gonna be three bolts, or usually, that screw into your harmonic balancer. They will be the right bolts, or they will be the wrong bolts. There is no in between. Putting a freaking wrench on this is gonna destroy your harmonic balancer, so it is either the right bolts or it's the wrong bolts. This guy threads in through here, and you want to put this tapered guy on the end so that this pushes the hole in the end of the crankshaft and does not damage the threads. But this, while it removes it, does not put it on. This is a kit that I bought to do a job on a PT Cruiser. Probably have a link somewhere on the PTSD Cruiser. And this one works kind of the same little way. You've got this crazy bolt that goes in through here. And then there's various rods of various lengths to poke through the hole in the crankshaft to push that all out. This one also removes. It does not install, but it's kind of handy. I used it once for one job. I think it was $100. A little bit disappointing. Always a good idea to leave the instructions in here so the next guy can know how this works. Except this one is mine, not the school's, so I'm taking it home. This one I bought for doing a Chevy LS that a student brought into the high school auto mechanic shop, and this one is supposed to hook into the LS harmonic balancer. This guy will be in the 30 caliber machine gun case in the tool room, except it doesn't work. This one, which seems really hokey, this worked for pulling off the harmonic balancer on the LS, which is weird. I guess this is probably the same one I used on my LS at home. Same kind of thing, except it hooks on and then pushes the crankshaft off the end. This puller will be in this 50 cal case in the tool room in the auto shop for gear pullers. There's all kinds of stuff for pulling gears, and in some engine cases, the harmonic balancer. With this, it's all in this case in the tool room. This one is one of my favorites. It's in the tool room as well on the ratty shelves, and it will remove it, but it'll also install it. The other kits remove the harmonic balancer, but they do not put it back on. This one will put it back on for you, and it works so well, I bought one for myself at home. Someone's going to leave a comment about being sponsored, whatever, go away. This isn't sponsored. These are just tools that work. You like this brand, buy this brand. You don't like the brand, buy a different brand. Nobody cares. This is the kit that works well for me. So inside here, oh look, instructions. Please make sure these go back for the next kit. Same thing before, there will be two or three or whatever screws you need for your harmonic balancer. They will be the right ones or they will be the wrong ones. And you're going to take this guy. And to take the harmonic balancer off, he fits in here like this. We've got, this just pushes into the threaded hole in the crankshaft so you don't destroy the threads. This guy fits on the back side like this. You're gonna take whatever bolts and washers, I guess I should show you with washers, or not maybe that size. So you're gonna have maybe three washers, you're gonna take three bolts and you put them there like this. These guys are gonna thread into the harmonic balancer, just like the picture shows. Save the pieces. These will thread with your fingers into the harmonic balancer. Then you hold this with a wrench, turn that with a wrench, and this thing pulls the harmonic balancer off, or if you wanna think of it differently, pushes the crankshaft out. Let's see how that works. This piece is glued to this piece. If you try to grab the outside of the harmonic balancer and pull it off by the outside, you will pull off the outside of the harmonic balancer and then it's junk and you have to buy another one. So never, ever, 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 isn't there a song like that? Don't grab it from the outside, grab it from the inside, from these bolts works really good. So that's how that harmonic balancer comes off. All right, you're joining this already in progress. I thread the stopper into the end of this. It's gonna push against the hole. This guy is gonna go on here. Notice it's got a bearing on the bottom. That's why I like this. This bearing pivots and it reduces a lot of the frictional stress on here. That's gonna go on here, but I am clearly too far away. This engine has fine thread imperial, and you want to try fasteners, and if they thread in with your fingers, it's the right size. If it does half a turn, it's the wrong size. Putting a wrench on it ruins everything. Pay attention to what fasteners go on there. So this is going to go in like so. Truthfully, you want to have at least the diameter of this thing sticking through, or if the threads are coming through on the backside, you know you're winning. These don't have to be done up super tight, but they do have to be super threaded. It's actually pretty easy to make sure you get it even because this thing sits right up against that. The flat face helps this pull equally. So then we just got to thread this off. And this harmonic balancer has never been off, so it might actually take a bit of effort. Oh, I broke free already. It's a good point for a ratcheting wrench. Bing, fries are done. When you're inspecting the harmonic balancer, we're looking at the quality of the elastic in here. It's rubber. Nothing lasts forever like the cold November rain. So if you have like dry weather cracking like an old tire in here, that's kind of junk. So you can see this silver line, that's where the rubber seal has been riding on here. And yeah, the rubber seal can actually wear a groove in the iron of this, which seems weird, but it does. Now you can repair this with a thing called a speedy sleeve, which is a really, really, really thin ring of steel that gets glued over top of that and gives you a fresh surface, a slightly thicker surface, which makes it seal a whole lot better. It's not bad. I would probably be inclined to put a speedy sleeve on there. Looks like the back isn't too bad. It looks like mostly grit on there. The rubber looks okay. While you're there, consider taking this groove and put some white paint in there so that you can find top dead center of your engine, or if you're checking spark timing. I always paint this fresh black with a nice white stripe so I can see this with my timing light when I put the engine back and I'm tuning it. Let's imagine this is our new harmonic balancer and we're putting the engine back together. In the kit, you'll find a variety of adapters that thread into here. This needs to thread into your crankshaft. If you take your crankshaft bolt, it looks like it's the same diameter and the thread actually meshes like this. If the threads mesh, you've probably got the right one and the diameter should be the same. I have kids work with small block Chevys a lot, so this one shows the most wear because I don't have the other engines. That's a Dodge, that's a Chevy. Makes sense that they're at opposite ends. This guy threads into here and then threads into the crankshaft. The end has a hex on it in case this stays when you take it apart. You can put a wrench and get this guy out as well. This kind of helps to put it all together. Okay, then this guy is gonna go on this way, and now we're gonna push the harmonic balancer onto the crankshaft or pull the crankshaft into it. Depends on where you are in reality. So a little bit of silicone on here because it is possible for the motor oil to leak through this and leak out the front of your motor. So when I do these, I usually put a little bit of a goop of silicone in here to go this way and then the keyway. And I usually put a little bit of silicone behind the washer here to hold it all in. I'm not going to with this because this particular engine has spun two rod bearings and taken out the crank. So I'm not too worried about what happens next. So now the flat surface is going to go against the harmonic balancer. This threads into the crankshaft. You will find a lot of videos on YouTube where guys beat this with a hammer to put it on. They're wrong. Abraham Lincoln says you can't trust everything you see on the internet just because there's a picture next to it. But this is what we need to do. Here, same thing. I'm going to use the wrench. Put this on here. And now I'm threading it into the crankshaft to push it all the way on. You will know when you get to the bottom, it will get noticeably tighter, and that's perfectly fine. You'll know. But if it keeps turning, you're not there yet. Probably be a good idea to put a little bit of oil on those threads. This thing is relatively oily, but it will last longer if you oil it. There we are, we're tight.
If we're lucky, it comes out of the crankshaft. Almost lucky, but it's got a hex on it in case you need to. We'll put this back in the case.
Please, for the love of mercy, put everything back in the kit. The bolts that you use, the washers that you use, the adapter, the plate, this, and for the love of mercy, please put the instructions in so the next kid can figure out how this can be worked. Or I guess they'd be watching this video. Like, share, subscribe. So, the basics on how to install and remove a harmonic balancer. There's different pullers for different harmonic balancers. We showed you where you need to pull it from, the inside, not the outside. We showed you the importance of putting everything back in the kit. We pulled it, we pushed it, we used the right thread, and this thing is good to go, regardless of what engine you have. You know, they all are gonna kind of be the same sort of thing. So, as always, thanks for watching, take care, and we'll see you again.